What's up, everybody? It's another fantastic day here at Quest Kids Online. I'm thrilled to see you guys. You're looking great from what I can tell in the screen right now. It's almost like you guys were made in God's image. Actually, you were made in God's image. And that means that you guys are full of creativity. Now, you may have also noticed I'm not alone today. I have a very special friend here by the name of NIrV. NIrV, say what's up to everybody.
It's Aram.
Aram, say what's up to everybody.
What's up?
Now, Aram, we're talking about this word creativity today and this month. Can you tell me what you think the word creativity means?
I think creativity means it inspires you to make art and music and follow in God's image.
Oh, awesome. So when you think about others with like art and music, if it allows you to follow in God's image, that's just kind of like the definition that we have for creativity. Our definition this month for the word creativity is this. Creativity is imagining what you could do because you're made in God's image. Why don't you, Aram, tell everybody at home the definition of the word creativity.
Creativity is imagining what you could do because you're made in God's image.
Awesome job. Now, here's something else that's really cool about creativity. It has no limits. God's creativity is limitless, which we can see whenever we look at the amazing world around us that he created. Think about it. Have you ever seen the exact same sunset? If you look closely, each sunset is different, with different strokes of color. It's almost like God is painting in the sky with his unlimited imagination, right?
Have you ever noticed how they're never the same?
Never the same.
That they're always moving and changing.
Right.
Have you ever played the cloud game where you stare at clouds and try to figure out what kind of shapes they look like?
Absolutely. Yeah, so when you play the cloud game, you look into the sky, and then if there are any clouds in the sky, that is, and then you try to figure out what they look like, what kind of shape they're in, right?
Animals, so, mountains,
right?
Anything.
Anything you can think of, your imagination, right? So actually, let's play a quick game, Aram. Let's play a creativity game. Let's play the cloud game, okay? We're going to take these cotton balls, and we're going to pull out a random item, okay, and then we're gonna try to shape them using our creativity, and then our teammates are gonna try to guess what they are, and then in 30 seconds, right, and then we're going to get another one, and we'll see who can win, okay? You guys ready? All right. Okay, so here we go. It's game time. Are you ready?
Yes.
Awesome. I'm ready. Our teammates behind the scenes are ready. They're going to be guessing for us. Okay, let's get started. Can you guys count it down for us? All right.
We're going to go down from five. Okay, you put your mic down real quick. All right. Count it down with us.
Five, four, three, two, one.
All right, grab yours and get, we're going to try to go really fast and try to make it right here, okay? Build it over here. Right there. Good. Okay, here we go. I'm making something, and let's see. It's close. Not really. I'm gonna let him see it. It is.
Okay, I think this is about as good as I'm gonna get it. What do you think? I don't know if clouds are this hard in real life. No, not a hand. Is yours banana? No? Okay, let's see. Okay, maybe we need to give them a hint. What do you think?
S.
Starts with an S over here.
Okay.
Starts with an A over here.
It's an apple.
It is an apple. That is an apple. Very good. Okay, that's one. That was a good snake. Okay, let's go for another one, okay? Let's try. We're gonna do three of these, okay? All right, here we go. Ready for the second one? Grab yours.
All right, I'm gonna grab mine. Ooh, okay. Ready? Go. Okay.
Opposite.
Yeah, don't give them too many hints yet. All right, here we go. This is gonna be so hard. They all look the same.
How is it a person?
Okay. Okay. I think that's good as I'm going to be. This is, okay, mine is something that you eat. Okay, this is something that you can see outside. You know what mine is? It's not a lollipop, no. That is the sun. That is the sun. Awesome job. Awesome job.
Mine is ice cream, and I tried to make a little ice cream cone here. It's tough. All right, it's 1-1 now. All right, ready for the next one? Tiebreaker here. All right. Who do you guys think is going to win? All right, Aram or myself? Here we go. Okay, you ready? Round three. Here we go. Grab yours. I'm gonna grab mine.
All right, here we go. All right, good, got that. Okay, ready? Let's go. All right, here we go.
What is it?
Let us form it.
It's a swing.
Oh, so mine is an animal, okay? It is an animal.
It's a
spider. No. Let's see here. Going around, it just looks like nothing. Now that I'm looking at it. Let me tighten it up here. That's a good one. Okay, I'm gonna turn it this way. Oh my goodness. It was a cupcake.
All right, so it was a cupcake. Very well done. You got me 2-1. What was mine? Any guesses? Okay, I can't hold it up or it's gonna fall. Let's see. It is a fish. That's dope. Yes. Now you see it. I have to hold it up a little bit. Without it falling. A fish, that was mine. So good job. Good job, good job, good job. Okay, thanks you guys for watching our game time. We had a lot of fun. Now it's time for us to spend some time in worship. You know, I love looking at clouds, but I also like to worship. Do you like to sing songs and dance?
Yes, I guess the game is over too.
Oh, yes, the game is over. So before we jump into our worship song though, we have a memory verse for this month. Ephraim, can you let them know what our memory verse is?
Lord, you are great. You are really worthy of praise. No one can completely understand how great you are. Psalm 145:3.
Awesome job. So our God is indescribable. Now let's sing out and tell him how we feel in worship today. Join us.
Show me how to live wherever
So great job worshiping with us at home today, you guys. Now, let's move into our Bible story. There was a man who wrote a lot of the books of the Bible, specifically in the New Testament. His name was what?
Paul.
His name was Paul. That's right. Now, Paul didn't always believe that Jesus was the Son of God.
Part of the group who killed Jesus.
He was. He persecuted Christians at one time. And then he had a dramatic experience and his life changed and his name was changed from Saul to Paul, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's right. Paul traveled all over the place to teach people and encourage them to follow Jesus too. And one of the letters Paul wrote was to the people in Ephesus, the Ephesians. And in his letter, Paul talked about how important it was for believers to get along with each other. And he reminded them that God created us to do good things for others.
Now, let's check out more of his story in today's video.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story. Inspired by the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verse 10.
When the apostle Paul wrote his letter to the believers in Ephesus, he told them, "We are God's creation. He created us to belong to Christ Jesus. Now we can do good works. Long ago, God prepared these works for us to do." Let's see how that might play out in someone's life today. Nora Gray followed her older cousin, Sadie, around the pottery studio. Clay dust danced in the sunbeams from high-up windows.
"So I just stay at the desk?"
Working at the Earth and Fire studio was Nora's first real job, and she wanted to get it right. Sadie grinned and pushed back her hair with a clay-flecked hand.
"Mostly. A bunch of artists have memberships here, so they can use all the equipment and materials. You'll answer questions, take calls, make orders when supplies run out, things like that."
"What's in there?"
Nora pointed to an open door near the back of the studio.
"Oh, yes, the closet."
Nora led the way over. Sadie peered inside.
"Wow."
The narrow room was lined on both sides with high shelves. Every shelf and every inch of floor space was crammed with a jumble of tools, containers of clay and glazes, cleaning supplies, and pieces of pottery, finished and unfinished.
"How do you find anything?"
"So many people use the closet. Everyone just kind of has their own system."
Nora didn't think the disaster in the closet qualified as a system, but before she could say anything...
"Oh, I gotta take this. Hello? Oh, hold on a sec. Where did I put my pen?"
Frazzled, Sadie checked her pockets. Nora quickly pulled a pen and notepad out of her neatly organized backpack.
"Would this work?"
Sadie snatched the pen and paper, mouthing, "Thank you," and headed for the desk. Nora surveyed the room. There were at least a dozen artists at work.
"You a potter too?"
Nora turned to see an older gentleman with a streak of clay in his curly white hair. His long frame bent nearly double over the nearest pottery wheel.
"Me? No."
"Oh, I think everyone's an artist of some kind."
"I can't even draw a stick figure. Sadie's just letting me work here till I go to college in the fall."
Nelson centered a lump of clay on his wheel.
"You'll see me here most every morning. I'm Nelson."
"Nora."
"Real nice to have you here. I'm working on a coffee mug if you'd like to watch."
Nora watched, mesmerized, as the spinning clay morphed from a stodgy lump to a smooth cylinder under Nelson's practice hands.
"I wish I could make beautiful things like that."
"You want to take a turn?"
"Sadie tried to teach me. It was a disaster."
Nelson smiled, hands still working the clay.
"I happen to believe that God made each of us to create beautiful things that matter. You'll find your spot."
Nora nodded, but she didn't think she'd ever create a piece of art that could make someone smile.
"Nora, I want to show you the kiln."
Sadie reappeared, and Nora spent the rest of the day learning the ropes of her new job. By early evening, the studio had cleared out.
"You go home. I can lock up at 6, just like you showed me."
"Well,
And I can order more blue glaze, like you said.
Well, if you think you got this, that would be great. I can get home early for dinner with the kids.
I'm good. Go, shoo!
With a wave, Sadie hurried out. Nora opened the supplier's webpage and started to order for glaze.
I bet there's still blue glaze in the closet somewhere.
Nora opened the door and clicked on the light. The mess looked even worse than it had that morning.
Is this glaze? Oh, it's those cans. And there's some over here and up there.
Nora edged her way around, collecting cans.
There's no way to know what's really here unless I can get it all together. I should clear a space. And I should stack those crates to group the colors.
Every time Nora moved one can or tool, she discovered six more that needed a place to go.
All the cleaning supplies can go down here, modeling tools and loops over there by the door. That's definitely trash. Oh, and there should be a spot for each artist to put their pieces that still need to be glazed.
One thing led to another, and another, and another. Nora finally realized she was hungry.
Where did I set my phone? Oh, here. 9:30?
Nora had been so focused on organizing the closet, she had completely lost track of time. She glanced with satisfaction at the crate containing five cans of blue glaze.
At least I don't need to order more glaze.
The next morning, Nora arrived a few minutes late. She rushed in, apologetic.
I'm so sorry, Sadie.
Nora broke off as she saw Sadie, Nelson, and several other artists grouped around the closet door.
Nora, did you do this?
I should have asked.
Nora, this is amazing!
Nora took a step forward to take a good look at what she's done. Glazes and clay, tools and supplies, everything had its own spot in a orderly rhythm. With the morning light streaming in, it did look pretty cool. Nelson grinned.
Oh, it's beautiful, Nora. A real work of art.
A younger woman with hair knotted on top of her head chimed in.
Plus, we can find stuff now. I thought I'd lost this set of mugs.
You've made our work a lot easier.
Really? I guess. I thought anyone could do this.
No way. You have a real gift.
Can I organize the front desk?
Please, I'm raising your pay.
Nora happily tackled her next project, a well-organized desk. She was grateful to discover the truth of Ephesians 2:10 in her own life. We are God's creation. He created us to belong to Christ Jesus. Now, we can do good works. Long ago, God prepared these works for us to do.
Can you imagine if we all used our creativity to help others? The world would be a better place and people would see and feel God's love through us.
That's what God created us to do. In fact, here's our bottom line statement for today. God created you so you can be creative.
That's right. God created you so you could be creative. Remember that creativity God gives us isn't just about art and music. God has designed you in a unique way to love him and to love other people. Now, let's ask God right now to show us how we can use creativity. Okay, would you guys pray with me? Here we go. Dear God, thank you for not only making us, but also sharing your creativity with us. We can see your creativity everywhere and it makes us want to be creative. Help us to do our best with all the gifts you've given us. Help us to see how we can use creativity to meet the needs of the people around us. We love you and we pray all of these things in Jesus' name. And you, Aaron said, amen. Amen. Awesome job. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. And we guys will see you next week. Say bye.
Bye.